Alright, so drove out into the woods today. It's a little chilly. It's in the high 30s. Everything's wet. It's been raining up here, I guess. But I just got a couple knives. I got this new little neck knife. And then the new Mora Full Tang Garberg. I figured I'd come test these out, stick around in the woods for a little bit, maybe see if I can get a little stick fire going. Heat up some water for a cup of coffee and oatmeal for late breakfast. So, let's see if we can get something going, huh? Woo! Okay, so I was able to wander off and get a couple pieces of dead wood. This one looks fairly dry. This one's kind of wet, but we'll see if we can't cut into the middle and hopefully it's dry on the inside. Might work. Test number one. Tawn some of these down. See how this works out. Nice. Yeah, it feels pretty dry inside. That's good. Oh yeah, that split super easy. So we get a couple for our base. Split some of these down even more. Might be a little damp, but we'll see. Ooh, yes. Never been very good at this, but this is also the first Scandi grand knife I've had. Seems to make a bit of a difference. It just kind of eats into the wood. You almost don't even have to press. I'm still not pro by any means, but it's definitely a lot nicer than my last attempts. Not the most beautiful work I've ever seen done. It'll work. Let me break some of these up a little more. Let's see if we can't get something going here. Ferro rod works well. A couple of them want to go. Try the little one. So one nice thing about this little bad boy is you don't have a lot of room, excuse my language, your knife's not gonna be in the end of everything here. A little easier to work with. Oh no. And I I've got a bit of fat wood I got the other day. And this stuff is awesome. Catches so easily. It's loaded with sap. Knife just eats into it. I could smell it from here. Now this stuff should take a spark. No problem. You can use the back of the knife, kind of scrape some of this stuff off. Is awesome. Let's see if I can get any of the rest of this shit going. Okay, so I got my little fire going. I got my water in the pot heating up. I realize that to eat my oatmeal, I should probably have a spoon, which I forgot. So, I'm just gonna make one here. And just so I can use a little more, I guess I'm gonna switch to a little knife. This thing is awesome. It's very easy to handle. Knocking all the shavings straight into my little fire here. Just gonna bevel the ends down so I don't poke a hole in my bag. So I will be cooking my oatmeal in a plastic bag. It's so much easier, and then you don't have to clean out your tin here. Decently thin, that should work. just like that. Hello, meal spoon. Let's see how the water's doing here. Actually, I'll narrow this down a little even more in the end. Then I will have a little scoop for this. Ooh, water's starting to go. So my fire's been going for a minute. I can hear the water starting to go. And although it's not at a raging boil, it's definitely hot enough for oatmeal. I'm gonna open up my bag. Easy way to keep it open. Fold it out on itself. And it stays open a little better. Set it down. Oh yeah, it's going good actually. I'm just gonna dump some of that into my oatmeal. And I always go light and then end up really mad because I end up with chunky, shitty oatmeal. So better to be a little watery. And I'm gonna let that sit for a sec. And then also what I have here is a tea bag that you get, empty tea bag. I fill it with coffee and non-dairy creamer to make camp coffee. Now it takes a little bit for it to soak through and get strong, but man, it is so much better than any instant coffee. One thing I usually have done, which I apparently forgot to do, is tie the top shut so you don't get any grounds in there, but we'll just kind of loop it around the back here so it doesn't go all the way in. That's it. Meanwhile, kind of squish up your oatmeal. That's going to be nice and hot. Woo! Get some of that extra heat out. That's pretty much it, guys. Easy way to do a camp breakfast and a pot of coffee. Mm-hmm. Whew. Smells good. Definitely do. Let's see how my coffee's doing. Once it soaks in a bit and this thing, you kind of gotta wring it out a little bit. Give it a good squish. It makes a decent cup of coffee. I can't stand the Taster's Choice. Is it Taster's Choice? Nescafe? I don't know, any of those. They're all absolutely horrible. I have one from Trader Joe's that's not bad. And then apparently the Starbucks ones are pretty good, but I have no clue. This has been my preferred method for a little while now. And it works great. It's hot. It tastes good, but it's hot. Woo. Thanks for tuning in if you're watching. I didn't make anything for a while because my SD card for my camera wasn't fast enough to record video, so I kept shutting off, which really pissed me off. So I kind of gave up on it a second. I just got a new SD card. Should be able to keep up with the video. So hopefully I start cranking some of these out. I got a couple backpack reviews I want to do on Osprey, which is awesome, by the way. So maybe check back later for one of those. Have a good one, guys.